Have you ever been using Ecamm Live and you're getting a little frustrated because what you are trying to set up and frame the shot for, you have all the buttons and icons that are there to help you operate your stream, but temporarily they're kind of in the way. So you just wish you could hide those? Well, I'm going to show you a quick tip that you can use to do that. All right, so here we are over in Ecamm Live. And as you can see, when I pull my mouse on the screen, I can see all my nifty icons to switch back and forth between maybe my 35mm lens versus the one I'm using today, which is a ZV-1 for this example. And the preview mode is kind of hiding what's in the corner. And if I wanted to go over to my screen mode and I wanted to make sure that this overlay, for example, is not blocking any of my branding icons or that they are even when I'm bringing them on the screen and all kinds of stuff, then I want to make sure that it's set up right. So let's fix a problem that you may run into before you run into it. If we go over here to the help screen, and you can do this for any tip that you need, and you just type in the word that you want. The one that we're using today is just hide. We want to go through and you'll see it'll pick out for you what are all the different things that you're trying to do or that's available under that keyword. You can go in and go through all of these different ones, but the one we're doing today is to hide the main window controls. And you'll see that to do that, we can either just click on it. And now with my mouse on the screen, I have full access and I can see that my air purifier is in the shot. So maybe I want to crop that out. Maybe I want to zoom in, or maybe I just want to take it and put it in the other room. Well, now I know that, but let's say now it's like, well, crap, I don't remember what the keyboard shortcut was. Well, if you go up here to the help, it will pull up the last thing that you just did or that last keyword. And then you can scroll through to see which of these was the one that you used. Or in this example, it's going to be command and the open quote or left quote symbol. I want to cut in here very quickly because I want to show you where you can find these icons on your keyboard. This is a Mac specific keyboard, but any third party brand or any keyboard that you have usually will have this next to your number symbol. That open left quote is right there underneath the escape and next to the number one there. The other thing is that usually right next to your space bar is your command button that you can find on your keyboard. And that's just a keyboard shortcut that you can use to kind of bring these on or off. So when this comes into play with using your overlays is I have my scenes locked. This is the pro tip here. Make sure you are enabling this lock symbol. So that way, when you are trying to do stuff, you're not accidentally resizing stuff and now you're hiding or making the mistake of just stuff going awry in the live stream. So if I wanted to readjust it, I'm like, well, crap, the bottom is seen, but I don't know how much or to where to stop dragging or whatever. Well, I'm going to go ahead and hit that command and the left open quote. And now I can go through and comfortably resize without having fear of hitting stop record or anything else. So let's go back to the just me screen. And now I'm ready to start streaming. Or maybe I want to zoom in a little bit on the ZV-1 and I want to hide that. And so now I can say, perfect. That's the shot that I want. And now I don't have to worry about you seeing my air purifier in the shot. And so I'm ready to go ahead and put this back. I'm going to hit command and the open left quote or the left quote button. And now I have my icons back on the screen. If you're new to using Ecamm Live, it's honestly super simple to use. You don't have to feel overwhelmed thinking that you need to use everything. So in the next video, I'm going to be showing you how to get started and get set up using Ecamm Live.